Good afternoon. Welcome to the SNP's annual conference, an occasion much enjoyed by party members across the country. Sadly, of course, we are meeting online again. Now, given current circumstances, this is sensible, but I really hope in spring we'll be together in person. Our debates and discussions, if not always the conference karaoke, are much better when we meet up, and I can't wait to see all of you again. Of course, being forced to take a political conference online is a mere inconvenience compared to the sacrifices made by so many over these past 2 years. Life today is much more normal than it was when I spoke to you a year ago. We have come so far, and while it has not been easy, a spirit of solidarity with and compassion for each other has helped us through. Now, as the emergence of the new Omicron variant has reminded us, we must harness that spirit again as we prepare for a winter that might be tougher than most of us have ever experienced. In recent weeks, we have had much in Scotland to feel thankful for. Compared to many countries across Europe, COVID cases here have been stable. Indeed, they have been declining slightly. To be frank, that is a much better position than I had dared hope for a couple of months ago. But there are big and very real challenges ahead over the winter months. Cases are rising in countries all around us. We know that colder weather forcing us indoors, coupled with festive socialising, will create increased opportunities for the virus to spread. And most seriously of all, the Omicron variant is causing profound concern here and across the world. So we must not drop our guard. This is a time to be more vigilant, not less. In the past few days, the new variant has led the Scottish Government to impose tighter restrictions again at our borders. A number of countries have been added to the travel red list. Travellers from these countries must go into managed quarantine. And we are asking all travellers, no matter where they are travelling from, to isolate until they get a negative result from a PCR test that they must do on day two after their arrival. We are also asking close contacts of any confirmed cases of Omicron to isolate. That none of this was even contemplated just a few days ago is a reminder, again, of how fast this virus can move and change. We must, all of us, therefore, redouble our efforts to stop it in its tracks. The good news is that we know how to do that. We have done it before. So today, before I talk to you about politics, I want to ask again for your help. Over these next weeks of winter, we need to pull together and look after each other. I promise that the government will do our job. That means getting all of you who are eligible vaccinated with boosters as fast as possible. Thanks to teams across the country, Scotland is already the most vaccinated part of the UK, but we will not let up. Instead, we are working to speed up. And while I still hope this will not be necessary, if difficult decisions do need to be made to keep us safe, we will not shy away from taking them. Steering the country through this winter is my priority. It is my duty. But no government can fight a virus alone. We all need to play our part. That was true before the detection of Omicron, and it is even more so now. If all of us increase our compliance with the protections already in place, we will help slow transmission. So I'm asking everyone to please take the time now to think afresh about the basic steps you can take to keep yourself, your loved ones, and the country safe. Wear a face covering in indoor public places, keep following hygiene advice, wash your hands and surfaces, open windows if you have people round, ventilation really helps, work from home if possible, and please, please, if you haven't done so already, get every dose of vaccine you are eligible for, including flu.